Did the media take a break from dividing America just because George H.W. Bush died? No. Let's put that stupid narrative in a coffin and un*** the news. Somber week in America. The 41st president of the United States has passed away, George H.W. Bush. He's a war hero, served in World War II, shot down over the Pacific at the age of 20, and was in public service for most of his life, culminating in his presidency in the late 80s and early 90s. America did pause this week, all of its politics, all of its division, to honor the man. But the media, meanwhile, was preaching to us about what an amazing moment it was that politics seemed to have stopped in America. That everyone seemed to be getting along, that for a moment our divisions weren't pronounced. Take a look.
A final salute to the 41st president of the United States is about to begin. This is CNN's special coverage of the state funeral of George Herbert Walker Bush. I'm Will Flitzer along with Jake Tapper as we await an extraordinary moment of mourning and unity in a divided Washington.
Wow, what a touching message. But interestingly, it took mere seconds for the press to revert back to form. And guess what? Divide us.
Donald Trump is 180 from who George H.W. Bush is.
This president that we have now is trying to unravel everything that he did and Obama did.
Because there are a lot of things about George H.W. Bush that maybe people now appreciate that they didn't appreciate the time.
There's a lot of focus on President Trump and his behavior during the funeral. What did he do? How did he offend everyone? He didn't. He just sat there and consumed the funeral like the rest of America, watching along, reverently, respectfully. If President Trump had walked in there and given a hug to Hillary Clinton, he would be criticized for how out of touch he was, how he didn't understand that that's not appropriate with a woman who doesn't like him. But instead, he didn't even really look at her. She definitely didn't look at him, and that became a scandal? The man didn't make the story about himself, and that became a scandal? Look at the way the press treated just the president attending a funeral for a former president.
George Bush believed in the institutions of government, which I think, too, is another reason why this moment to remember and to compare and contrast is so important, because our institutions are so under siege right now by the government itself.
And that is why we celebrate George H.W. Bush's legacy and fear the next 2 years.
Over on CNN, they were talking about whether or not Barack Obama even should have shook the hand of Donald Trump.
The Obamas are really classy folks, because I don't know if I could be so if we can put that up.
It's hard for them to not want to look at us the whole time.
It's hard for them. No.
So the Obamas, what did you see that you want people to be reminded of?
I want to say that I don't think I would shake hands with them. I don't know. I would just, nope, couldn't do it. I'm not that big a person.
What kind of inane coverage is this? Isn't the point to actually bring the country together? You know, for a moment, to stop dividing the country, to stop exploiting it for your cool purposes, to add ratings, to advance the purposes of the Democratic Party, whatever your goals might be. Couldn't you take a breather for a second, absorb some of the emotionality of the day, honor the sacrifice that this man made for our country by serving in World War II and ultimately becoming president of the United States? No, it's far more fun to attack the current president of the United States, who you have utter contempt for not mouthing along during the Apostles' Creed. While the rest of us were in mourning or appreciating the kind words that were said about the former president of the United States, the media was busy attacking the current president of the United States, going after him for his posture.
The president sitting often with his arms akimbo like this, when everyone else was prayerfully looking forward, they were not exchanged. I mean, there was one handshake with the Obama sitting closest to him, but no other interchanges that we could see.
Great life of a great president, a great American. Instead, the media is focusing on, yet again, dividing us. It's a good example of where the press constantly has somebody else's interests at heart and not those of the American people.
It just gives you a sense of the big character of the man and the contrast with the small character we see today.
Note the duplicity here. On the one hand, you have the press saying how great it is that Americans are finally coming together. But on the other hand, they're the force that's seeking to divide us. Use opportunities like this to come together and ignore the media. They don't have your interests at heart. I'm Vince Coglianese, and I just unf***ed the news. While a lot of the press don't have your interest at heart, the Daily Caller definitely does. First and foremost, we care about America, and I know you do too. If you're interested in what we produce, please subscribe to The Daily Caller. Click the link wherever it appears around me. You definitely should, and tell your friends.